Here we go with another story, Wild Duck. Wild Duck, written by Ramesh Gunasekara. He was born in Sri Lanka and lives in Britain. Having spent his early years in Sri Lanka, he explores many aspects of his native land in his writings. His fiction has been translated into many languages. The wild duck. They'll come from over there. The man pointed at a red volcanic hill. Okay, volcanic hill. What is the speciality of a volcanic hill? Yes, it seems it's red. He and the boy both had guns resting across their knees. They sat facing each other in a small motionless boat with the oars tucked in. Are you ready? He asked his son. Yes. They come in crowds, huge crowds moving very fast. He moved his arms in a wide sweep, rocking the boat. You have to be quick. Shoot fast. The boy ran his finger down the cold blue barrel of his gun. Minute by minute, the light changed on the flat surface of the water. Orange, red, mostly from the sky. It was late afternoon. I like in a wilderness. You load it? Yes. Remember, aim well ahead. You have to imagine the flight path. To be dead on is not easy, but you have to manage with just one shot. I know. Suddenly, the boy looked up. Is that them? A ribbon of black dots spill out of the horizon? The boy was spellbound. Breath whistled out of his small round mouth. Watching birds was his passion. There must be millions, the dad exclaimed. Half the sky was covered by teal. Huge clouds of them banked one way, then another, changing the shape of the sky and blotting the light. The sky deepened, the water turned black. Small groups broke away, diving, then rising in perfect formations. Will they all land here on the lake? They look too high. I think they are aiming for somewhere else. Who decides? They know. Then they were overhead, the sky filled with masses of birds in flight. A flurry of birds' calls. Father and son looked at each other. Here goes, the man undid his safety catch and started firing, throwing buckshot at the sky. The explosion shook the boat. The lake rippled. He pumped the gun empty. Too high. They're flying much too high. His son slowly raised his rifle. He had a more patient and sturdy hand. He picked a single speck out of the mass in the sky. The lead of a formation flying towards them. He aimed and fired. The speck plummeted. What do you mean by plummeted? Fell very fast and suddenly. You got the leader, the man cheered. Another bird swiftly took its place. They were all leaders by instinct. By instinct in the way animals naturally behave, without having to think or learn about how to act. I want to find it. The boy put down his rifle and took the paddle. Did you see where? It fell just behind the bulrushes. Go around that way. Plants with tall stems that grow near rivers and lakes. The boy moved the boat against the tide of teal. The teal, the large flock of wild duck moving together, still wheeling overhead. His arms trembled as he pulled the paddle through the black water. I think I can see it, he said, leaning forward. There was a lamp floating on the water. On it was a broken wing, pointing at the sky like the red sail of a toy boat. The boy lifted the paddle and they glided up to it. He bent over the side and scooped it up. Well done, the man said. His son was silent. The duck was big, helpless. Touching its soft feathers and its thin, bony neck, the boy looked frightened at what he had done, and he was feeling very guilty on that time. Then the duck lifted up its head. "Look, it's not dead." The blood seemed to flow again in the boy's arms. He breathed in relief. The duck looked blank. The boy stroked its head. "I want to go home." "You'll have to look after it." I know, I want to." At home, the boy bandaged the wing and learned to feed the maimed duck. What do you mean by maimed? Injured so severely that a part of its body no longer worked
as
it should.
He spent hours watching it waddle about the back.
Sometimes it would stretch its neck and try to flap its lopsided wings, but it could never fly again. One day, the man asked his son, "Where is the gun?" "I threw it away," he said defiantly, boldly refusing to obey. "You what?" A way of expressing unpleasant surprise. "What was it you said you did?" asked the man, shocked at his son's boldness.
"It was mine. You gave it to me."
"But it didn't kill your duck. It gave you your duck." "It made me sick." The man felt the blood pumping in his head, and then he was filled with a sense of peace. He felt he was relieved the gun had gone. By the boy's words, the man realized that he was really correct, that the boy is correct, and he found he was very relieved the gun had gone. He found that the boy has become very relaxed. The gun had gone. So that was the end of the lesson, and the boy had a kindness towards that creature, towards the duck.